Hey guys, welcome back to Sparkman Homestead. My name is Krista. I have such a fun recipe planned for today, and I wanted to bring you guys along while we experiment making it. Recently, I picked up a cookbook from my local library. Well, I didn't pick it up. I borrowed it from my local library. I love to do that in order to kind of test drive cookbooks. If I can find them at the library, I will borrow them. And then if there is a lot of recipes in it that I absolutely love, I will usually go and purchase that cookbook. I just kind of like to give it a little bit of a test drive. That way I'm not really wasting money. Unless the cookbook has come like very highly recommended from a lot of people, then I'll usually go and buy it without test driving it first. But this was a cookbook that looked interesting, and I didn't end up going and purchasing it because there was only a couple recipes in it that I kind of thought I would like. This was one of them, so we are going to give it a try today. I got it from an Amish cookbook. If I can find the cookbook on Amazon, I will leave it linked for you guys in the video description. So I am not going to try to pronounce what the official name of this recipe is called. I will leave it below for you though. The English translation of it is meat buns. So essentially what it is it's just a dough with a meat filling in it, and then you make it into a ball, and they're really, really little shaped, and then you just cook it that way. So this recipe makes 80 of them, so it makes quite a bit. We're not gonna obviously eat 80 of these buns for supper. So my hope with this recipe, and the recipe does actually say that it is a very, very good freezer recipe. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have some for supper tonight, and the extra amount we're just gonna throw in the freezer, and then I'll be able to have that as a freezer meal one night. And if they're really, really small, it may actually work out to be like a really nice appetizer to have in the freezer as well. So I got the dough pre-made. The reason I got the dough pre-made is because we are having some insanely freezing temperature. It's like minus ridiculous outside right now. Well, maybe not ridiculous for you northerners, but for us who live in the south, it is like you can't even think straight, so cold. So I got my dough pre-made ahead of time, just so that it has a little extra time to rise while we're getting the meat filling done, because the meat filling has to kind of cool a little bit before we can make everything. But I did actually videotape me making the dough just so that I could show you guys the whole process. The other fun thing that I did while the dough was rising, I went and picked up my Azure pickup for this month. So we are definitely in the pantry challenge, but I stated on my video a while ago at the very beginning of this pantry challenge that I was still giving myself a couple of exceptions, or not really exceptions. They're gonna be my rules for this pantry challenge. That's the one thing that's really, really nice about it, is that you can literally make your own rules. There's no set rules you have to do with this pantry challenge. So I told myself that I was going to allow myself to get produce and dairy products. So pretty much that is what's in my Azure order. I think there's a couple of things that are not. I'm actually not even going to be using them this month. I purchased them because they were probably on sale. That is one thing that I will definitely still be doing well on the pantry challenge, is when I can find things that are on sale, I'm gonna still be purchasing them, because that's how I save money, is you buy things when they're nice and cheap and you buy them in bulk so that you have it to last you a while until hopefully they become on sale again. I will show you what I picked up for my Azure haul once we get that filling all cooked and that is cooling down. I have all of my stuff in my garage right now, which my garage is the temperature of a refrigerator right now. So it is fine to sit on the garage floor and just wait for us to get this done. So the dough is pretty much risen. It is kind of huge here. Again, this makes 80 of these buns. I'm hoping that this recipe is good because it makes a lot of food. The other thing that I have sitting out trying to cool down is some ground beef. This recipe calls for 3 pounds of ground beef. We have to get some cream of mushroom soup made because we also need to have that in here. And then what are some other things we need? We need breadcrumbs. Right now, I'm just telling you what we need for the meat filling. So we need 3 pounds of meat, 1 10-ounce can of cream of mushroom soup, a cup of breadcrumbs, and then a package of dry onion soup mix. I have pre-made some dry onion soup mix. I'm not sure if it was last week's video that I mentioned this or not, but I was saying that I'm thinking I need to do an updated video for you guys, just kind of showing you how I make all of my spices. I think it was on a couple weeks ago because I was explaining about my everything but the bagel seasoning. So anyways, I'm thinking I need to make some more of this onion soup mix, but we do need to have a 4-ounce package of this, so I'll just weigh this out on my scale so that we can get 4 ounces of it. So let's get started making the cream of mushroom soup because we have to add that into our beef filling. I have shown you guys so many times on my cooking videos how I make my cream of mushroom soup. It is so, so easy to make. So I'm just getting 3 tablespoons of butter here. If you want, you can actually even use lard in this. I'm just gonna put it on probably about a medium high, and we're gonna get that melted. I'm gonna get a whisk out. Now, the recipe that I am using, I'm going to leave it linked for you guys. It is for a cream of chicken soup, but one way I make it a cream of mushroom is I just add this seasoning that I picked up from Trader Joe's. It gives it that extra kind of mushroom taste, and it just, I found that it just makes a perfect cream of mushroom soup. Another thing that I've done too is I've dehydrated mushrooms. I'm wondering if I want to put some mushrooms in this. We may add a couple mushrooms to this too because the recipe does say cream of mushroom soup. I dehydrate them when I can find them on sale. So we'll add maybe a couple of those to that as well. You can like use this recipe also to make like a cream of celery soup as well. You could just add celery in with it or like a celery seasoning. And then I have my flour out, I have some milk out, some chicken broth, all of the things that go in it. I'll give you the exact measurements as we're going along. So we're just going to wait for this butter to melt. I'm going to bring you guys down so you can actually see what I'm adding to the pot. Okay, it's pretty melted, so let's add our flour. We're going to add 3 heaping tablespoons of flour. And we want to cook this until the flour smell is kind of off. Now I have spilt some on the burner there, it kind of stinks. Want to just kind of be able to smell a nice nutty smell. Okay, it's smelling nice and nutty. So what we're gonna do is stir in very, very slowly 1/2 cup of chicken broth. And then we want to get 1/2 cup of milk. That's it. Now, if you find that this is a little bit too thick for you, you can actually thin it out with a little bit more chicken broth. I think I'm gonna thin mine out just a touch bit more. That's good. And then I'm gonna add some salt and pepper to taste. So maybe like 1/4 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. Maybe not so much pepper. I'm gonna turn my element off because it does stay hot for a while. And then I'm gonna come in and probably add about 1/2 teaspoon of this mushroom seasoning. And then a little handful of these mushrooms. You can actually use fresh mushrooms in this as well. Probably added about 1/4 cup. Hard to see because it's really steamy, but it's got a nice mushroom smell to it. We're just gonna set this aside. Okay, I'm gonna turn my heat on to a medium. I'm just looking for my scissors right now. And then we're gonna get our ground beef put into this really big cast iron skillet. It's, I don't know what size it is. It's like one of the really big large ones. So what we need to do is we need to fry the ground beef until it is barely cooked, and then we need to drain the excess fat. So let's get that hot. Some of this is still a little frozen. I took it out last night, let it kind of thaw in my fridge, and then I took it out this morning hoping it would thaw a little bit more on my countertop, but it's just, like I said before, it's like ridiculously cold. It's getting my hands washed. I'm gonna use my meat chopper. Most of it's thawed out, it's just a little tiny bit of it that's frozen, but it'll cook. Okay, I wanna get this onion soup mix measured out. Just gonna get my scale. We need 4 ounces. Okay, I feel like that's a lot. That says it's 4 ounces. We are grounding for 3 pounds of meat, so I guess it's not too much, but we're only using 1 can of cream and mushroom soup, so that's weird. I'm hardly got any left, so now I actually have to make some of the mix with you guys. So maybe that'll be next week's video. Have to get my breadcrumbs out. sourdough breadcrumbs. And we need, what do we need? 1 cup of these. I like to get everything kind of set out and ready. That way when the meat is ready to go, we just have everything all ready just to add into it. Because we have to let this cool quite a bit. Don't want to cook it all the way through either. It says just barely cooked. This is the dough back here. I'm hoping that it doesn't rise too much. Just gonna wet this actually, because that's looking a little dry. Okay, put this back on. I'm so excited to show you guys a couple of the things that I picked up through Azure this month. I got a couple of things for gardening season and I'm really excited about them. But we have to get this done first. We have to do this before we can get to the really fun stuff. Not that cooking's not fun. I enjoy cooking. I'm gonna take it off the heat and drain it because the recipe does say to have it barely cooked. And there is a lot of grease in here. So I have a bowl and then I just put a strainer over top of it because I'm not gonna dump this grease down my drain. That would not be good. I got it drained. I'll show you how much grease came off that. It's ridiculous. I'm gonna add this back into this here. I have the heat turned off here. Look at how much, I don't know if you can see, a lot of grease. I'm gonna save that though. So we need to add the remaining ingredients. So we need to add our dry onion soup mix. Again, that was 4 ounces. It just says 1 package. That seems like that's almost 2 packages. Then we need to get our cream of mushroom soup. Just gonna get a spatula out here. Hopefully you guys can see. I'm gonna empty that in here. I feel like this almost needs 2 cream of mushroom soups. It just says 1 10-ounce can. And then we need 1 cup of breadcrumbs. Breadcrumbs are kind of frozen. Everything's frozen at this point. Okay, let's give this a stir. Just says to get everything good and combined. We have to cook it for 5 minutes, it says. This is a little dry. I'm just gonna add just a tiny bit more of this grease back in because I think I maybe potentially drained it too much because it just says excess fat. So I'll just a little bit more back in. I'm gonna turn the heat off of this. This is fine. I'm gonna actually put it in a bowl and probably put it in the fridge. That may help it cool down a little bit more than just leaving it out here. Because we need to get it really good and cool down. The problem with using this pan is that it is so heavy. I can't lift it up. I don't want to burn my countertop. Get one of these warmers. Maybe I can get it lifted up. Some stuff to the bottom of the pot or pan. I'm not going to put that burnt stuff in there. We're going to put this in the fridge. Let that cool down for a couple of minutes. Let's come over here and then we get to look and see what we got for Azure. Ooh, that sun is really bad. Here it is. So I'm gonna show you the big stuff before we get to the box stuff. So I got this bag of, I'm gonna just show you guys what the name is because I don't know how well I'm gonna pronounce that. Gypsum, I think it's pronounced. We have really, 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 really bad clay soil here. And I've done quite a bit of research and apparently this is supposed to be really good for helping break up that clay in the soil. It even says right on the bag, good for breaking up clay soil. So we're gonna try to put a little bit of this into our garden. At the beginning of the season, I'm just gonna lightly till it in. I do try to practice a majority of a no-till garden, but I think because I'm dealing with such bad clay and just the water doesn't drain very well. The soil is just really bad. I think for the first couple of years, tilling is kind of gonna be my option. I do really try to practice the no-till, but sometimes it just kind of requires a little bit of tilling. So I'm going to try to till this in at the little tiny bit at the beginning of the year, and then in the fall I'm going to till it in again and then cover the garden. So I picked up some of that. Again, like most of my Azure hauls, I will just leave the prices below for you guys so that you know what I paid. This is the month of January 2024, so those are the prices for that particular month. The other big thing I picked up was some fertilizer from Azure. I've heard good things about this fertilizer, so I thought I would give it a try. It's a 432 fertilizer, so we'll see. Hopefully it'll be good for the garden. I'm gonna try to put some of this down when I'm putting in my tomato plants and everything, just kind of lightly till it in. Now for the fun box stuff. I'm hoping the lighting is not too bad. Get some scissors, open these up. So this very first box is a box full of butter. I went through so much butter during the holiday season. I thought I better just get a box of it just to kind of make sure that I stay stocked up. Plus I've been hearing that butter is getting harder to get. So I got, how many come in here? 18 1-pound packages. This is my favorite butter. This is Mother's Choice butter, and I just get the salted. I like cooking with salted butter. I don't find that it really makes a big difference when it comes to like my baked goods. I picked up 18 of those. Okay, let's do this little box first. I have no idea what is in here. Oh, okay. This little thing for this box. So I got some of this tea. This is my favorite tea. I don't drink coffee. I know I've mentioned it many times on my videos, but this is really, really delicious. It is a great coffee substitute. I was ordering from the actual company's website, but it is actually a tad bit cheaper to get it from Azure Standard. Now, the company did make an announcement recently that they were going to be increasing their prices come 2024. So that's the other reason why I wanted to pick some up from Azure this month before that price increase kind of gets impacted with Azure. So I picked up, this one is a hazelnut one. I really, really enjoyed that one. And I think I got a couple more of those. Not this particular kind, but I think a couple of different ones. We'll see. Oh, okay, this is just one thing. Got some broccoli, some frozen broccoli. Unfortunately, my fall garden did not do very well for my broccoli, so I picked up these ones. They are super, super small. You can see the size of them there. They're really small, but Steven really likes the size of them. He loves the Azure broccoli because they are super small and they make really good broccoli soup. So got a 5-pound bag of that. And then this month I picked up 3 of my sour creams. We went through so much sour cream that we actually had to go and get some from the store because we had none left. For some reason right now, we are just eating a whole bunch of sour cream. I should have really bought 6 of them because you do get quite a good deal when you buy the 6, but I just picked up 3. Hopefully they'll last us. And again, this is stuff that I said at the beginning of the pantry challenge was that I was going to allow myself dairy and produce. So that's so far where we're at. Now, this is something that I picked up. I'm not going to use this month or next month because it is it's a pantry item. And I said I wasn't going to be using any of this, but I wanted to get some of this. This is some white beans. These are small navy beans. So I'm just going to put these away in storage. I used up the last of them recently, and I just want to make sure when we are done this pantry challenge that I still have some in my pantry. So I'm not going to use them. So I'm not technically cheating off of my rules. I just wanted to get them just because it was in this budget this month, just to make sure that when we are done, I have them available. And I don't need them right away because I just canned up a whole bunch of beans the other day. So those I won't have to worry about using them. So this is some more of this tea. This one is really, really good. I love having the tea bags because it's really easy. If I have to go to an appointment somewhere and I don't have time to like brew it, because normally I brew this stuff through my pour over brewing system. So it does take a little bit to brew. So I can just plop a tea bag in some hot water and go. And I I just like having that option available. And then I also got another of the, I guess it's like a loose leaf, but it's not really like a loose leaf tea. I'll show you what it looks like. Hold on.
This is a package that I already had purchased a long time ago from the actual company, but I don't know if it's gonna pick it up or not. But this is what it looks like. It's just, it almost looks like coffee grounds in a way, but it's got like some herbs in it. And it smells just amazing. Love it. Put this back here. So I just use this to brew that. I just put a filter in here. Sometimes I don't even use a filter. And this is how I brew these bags. I'm really promoting that company. I think I said it on a video a while ago. I really wish I was sponsored by them because I cannot recommend them enough. Like there, it is amazing, amazing, amazing company. And then we got some more smoked cheddar cheese. We went through that whole block that we purchased last month. It is our favorite, favorite, favorite cheese. It smells so, so good. So this is a 5.68 pound block. I think it's sold as a 5 pound block, but you get a little bit more. And this is that, just the smoked cheddar cheese, and Romano is the company that makes it. So, so, so good. So just to forewarn you, this is a feminine product that's coming up next. I have purchased these from Azure, I think 2 months ago, and I love them. Love, love, love them. These are period underwear. They are amazing. They fit perfect and they work really, really good. So it's a medium absorbency. So it's supposed to replace 2 tampons. I love these. They are perfect. I looked on Amazon for some of these and I just wanted to kind of make sure that I wasn't wasting my money and buying a product that didn't work really well. Like I wanted to make sure it worked. So I thought, let me just give them a try. Azure just came out with them, I think 2 months ago, and I have ordered a pair every single month since they came out because I love them. They are very, very good. So I picked up a pair of those. So that is it for my Azure haul this month. It was really, really small because we are on the pantry challenge and I'm not really stocking up right now. I'm just kind of trying to eat through what we have, with the exception of like things like this. Let's check and see what our filling is looking like and then we will get back to making that. First, I actually have to put all of this stuff away. Now, I store my butter in the freezer, so I'm just gonna go and put this in the freezer and go and make room for 18 one-pound packages in my freezer, which I don't think I have room for, but we'll try and see if we can find room. I just poked a hole in that fertilizer bag and got that fertilizer all over my floor. I don't know if you've ever smelt fish emulsion, but that fertilizer smells like fish emulsion. So I'm trying to get it sweeped up right away because it doesn't smell the greatest. I taped it up right away, put it in my garage and taped it up. It's gonna go up my greenhouse. It smells very, very fishy. Need to get these beans put away also, so I'm gonna put them in a jar that I already have. I don't know if this jar is gonna be big enough. This is where I had them before. I just need to actually wash my hands though because I was touching all those boxes. Hopefully it fits. No! Half of it fits. Oh no, that's fine. I'll just leave the other half in my pantry. I like to take the labels off. They actually peel off really, really, really easily. And then you can see it peels off really easily. And then I like to stick them on the front of my jars because it also has directions on the back how to like cook it and stuff. But I usually end up just canning my beans anyway. So we'll leave this in the kitchen pantry and then this will go in my kind of backstock pantry. But again, I'm not going to be touching these during the pantry challenge, which I'm going to be doing it January, February, so 2 months. That's the other thing too I didn't mention with those teas. I'm not going to be using those. The only reason I purchased them this month was because
I heard the price was going up and I wanted to make sure I got a good stock of it before the price went up. So that is also a no-go. Once I run out of my stuff that I have right now, I will just default to drinking my Yerba Mate tea because I do enjoy that also. Being accountable for following through for what I say, no groceries other than dairy and what I say, dairy and fresh produce. So we're now gonna get finished on those meat buns. Before we get started filling them, I do wanna show you guys how I actually made this dough. So I'm gonna include that clip right here. And then when we come back, we will get to the next step of getting these filled and letting them do their second rise. So here's that clip. In a medium-sized saucepan, you can also do this in the microwave, you want to mix together 2 cups of water, 2 cups of milk, 1 egg beaten, 2 teaspoons of salt, and 1 cup of a fat. So the recipe suggests using 1 cup of lard, and you want to have that melted. I didn't have 1 cup of lard, so I actually came in and added 1 cup of butter. It's perfectly fine to use butter interchangeable with lard. And then you're just going to heat that up until it is nice and warm. It says do not boil it, just heat it until it is hot. As I mentioned earlier, you can do this on the stovetop or you can do it in the microwave. I just felt that doing on the stovetop was a little bit more manageable for me. In a very, very large bowl, and I would strongly recommend not using a stand mixer like mine in this, and you'll see why, it just too much mixture for this tiny little thing. If you have one of those really big mixtures, then that's perfectly fine to use it. Otherwise, I would definitely recommend just doing this in a really big bowl. So you're gonna mix together 8 cups of an unbleached all-purpose flour. You can use actually any flour that you would like in this, and you're going to stir in 1.5 tablespoons of an instant yeast. I just used an instant dry active yeast and it was perfectly fine in this. So you're going to mix those two together, and then you are going to pour that hot liquid over top of that flour and yeast, and you're going to stir it until it becomes too difficult to mix together with a spoon. It says to knead this dough for 8 to 10 minutes, adding up to 2 cups of flour until it becomes soft but not sticky. So you can see here why I'm not recommending using a stand mixer. It was just too much for my poor little machine and it was just going everywhere. It was getting to be a complete mess. I think I actually ended up coming in and adding about 3 more cups of flour to this just to get it to the nice consistency that I needed it. You can see also it's a very, very sticky dough. So that 3 cups of flour, I needed it just to kind of get it to be that soft texture that I needed. I ended up giving up on my stand mixer after a while because it was just starting to clog the top of the stand mixer and I thought this is gonna wreck my stand mixer. So I ended up taking it out and kneading it for about 5 minutes. Once it was kneaded, I put it into an oil bowl and I let it sit for about an hour. I probably actually let this sit for a little longer than an hour just because my house was so cold. It probably sat for maybe about 2 hours. Plus I was going to do my Azure pickup, so it just was kind of on the stovetop just rising away. Okay, so we get to do the fun part. We get to punch this down. I don't know how far it's gonna go down. Oh, it does go down quite a bit. I originally had like a different cover over it and it was all stuck to it because it was risen all the way up to here. So I had to take the cover off and it kind of deflated it a little bit. Again, I hope these weren't over risen because I had to leave them to go to my Azure pickup. And that pickup was a little bit of an issue happening there, but we got it dealt with and it was all good. Okay, so once the dough is risen, we need to punch it down, which we just did. So now we need to pinch off golf ball size portions. Like, I'm guessing like this size, maybe that's a golf ball. I think that's a golf ball. And then it says flatten with the palm of your hand. I'll bring you guys down so that you can see everything. And then it says to put 1 teaspoon of the cold meat in the center. So I don't know how much we need to flatten it down before we put the meat in. I actually have to grab the meat. Okay. All right, I'm gonna bring you guys down. It's kind of hard to see over there. Okay. Let's get a spoon out. I'm thinking that that's pretty good to be flattened down. And then it says to take 1 teaspoon of the chilled meat mixture. It's kind of still a little warm, but it should be fine. And then make a little package by pinching the dough together. Like this. Says to place the filled buns seam side down on a parchment lined baking sheet. And then we need to cover these and let them rise for 30 more minutes. just trying to read over the recipe to see. Okay, so the meat can be made ahead of time and frozen. Thaw in the fridge until ready to use. To reheat, thaw buns in roasting pan. So I guess what we'll do for the frozen ones is we will just pre-make them like we are right now, but instead of letting them do that additional 30-minute rise, we'll just put them in a freezer bag with the directions on how to cook them, and then we'll just throw them in the freezer, I guess. Maybe that's what we'll do. It doesn't really explain anything about it, so hopefully that's okay. Alrighty, let's get these done though. It says it makes 80 of them. Looking like a little envelope, like a package, it says. The other thing it doesn't mention is how far apart, like what space we need to leave in between. I don't think that these are gonna rise like a lot. So I'm gonna guess that we'll leave like maybe like that much space. Hopefully it'll be okay. I don't know how much these rise. I've never made them. Again, we're experimenting together. It's fun to experiment. That was a little bit of sarcasm. I mean, I do like trying new recipes, but when we're making 80 of them, it's a little bit of a risk. We'll see. I did try a little bit of this filling though, and it does taste pretty good. I definitely feel like we're gonna have a lot of meat mixture left over, which is fine. I can just freeze this and then always make more of the dough. Because as you've seen, the dough is super easy to make. Maybe my golf balls are too big. I got one done, so it's underneath a wet cloth. We're gonna leave that sit for 30 minutes. I'm gonna get another one made. Right now, just to have for supper tonight too, because I don't think that's gonna be enough. They're pretty small and the meat inside them isn't very much meat. So I'm gonna get a second tray done. We're gonna let these rise for 30 minutes, and then after the 30 minutes, we'll come back and bake them and then do a little taste test and see how they are. So I will see you guys back in 30 minutes once those are done rising. The 30 minutes is up. So what we're gonna do, I have my oven preheated at 400 degrees. So I decided, well, I didn't decide. I made them all. What I decided to do was instead of flash freezing them like I'd said earlier, I think what we'll do is just pre-make them all and freeze them already cooked, because the recipe doesn't say anything about flash freezing. It just says that when you thaw them, just make sure they're completely thawed and then you cook them in a roaster oven. So I'm guessing because if we flash freeze them, we will omit the rise time. I'm guessing that that should be fine. It's, again, experiment like I said earlier. So we're just gonna cook them all. So we're gonna be in here for a while cooking these. But these ones are done, waiting for this to come up to 400 degrees. The other really cool thing that I got was I got some leftover filling. So we don't have any more of the buns left over. I actually have to get this covered with a wet towel. Hold please. Okay, I have my wet towel here. I'm just gonna cover these up. Just leaving these ones over on my table just to rise for 30 minutes. The cooking time on these is 15 to 18 minutes. Again, my oven usually cooks a little bit, takes a little bit longer. So we'll air on the 18 minute side. And then it does say remove from the pan to a cooling rack immediately, and then you store them in the fridge or the freezer. So that's why I was thinking that you can't just put them in before they do like that bulk rise in cooking. So I think we have to pre-make them. But what I was saying earlier was that we have leftover filling mixture. So I'm just gonna label this meat buns, put this in the freezer, and then when I want to make the buns again, I will just have to make a really small batch of the dough, and then we can just make some fresh ones. So this is going to go into the freezer. It's a pretty, it makes a quite a bit of food for that recipe, but again, it is 3 pounds. So okay, we'll be back once the oven's preheated. We'll get those in, and then I can't wait to try them. We're gonna get these in the oven. It doesn't say anything about putting like an egg wash on it or anything, so we'll see. We'll do this first batch, and then if I think maybe we need to add an egg wash, then we'll re-add an egg wash, but they didn't really rise anymore on that second one, so we'll see. All right, let's get this timer set for 18 minutes, and then we still have this second one, and when those ones come out of the oven, I will transfer the ones that are over there rising onto that other cookie sheet. We'll just do like an assembly line. out in, until we get them all cooked, and then we'll let them cool completely before we flash freeze them. I still have a minute and 19 seconds left, but I'm gonna check them because I can really, really smell them. Take my glasses off so I don't fog up. I think they need a couple more minutes. We'll just take one out and check it. Oven's hot. This is what it looks like. Do I try to break it open or do I get a knife? Let's get a knife. It smells really, really good. Yummy. This is exactly like a meat pie. I'm just checking to see if they're done, like if the dough is done. I'm gonna leave them in for a couple more minutes because. Yeah, I think the dough. Dough could probably go a couple more minutes. They're good. It's kind of bland though. Like, I feel like they need something with it. Like, it needs like a dipping sauce, like maybe like a ranch dipping sauce. It definitely tastes like the inside tastes like almost like a hamburger patty, but it's missing something. Maybe it's because it's not spicy and I feel like it should be spicy. But it's good. It's really good. Good dipped in something. I like them. The next batch, we're going to do an egg wash because I feel like maybe that's what it's missing. So I have an egg. I have a little bit of water in here. Let's make an egg wash. Up my mess. Okay. So we're gonna put an egg wash on these and then we'll do an experiment and see which one I like better. It is so cold out right now that my chicken's eggs are freezing. Like, I'm pretty sure, because I haven't had a chance to go out there today, pretty sure all of those eggs are frozen in there. It's a tragedy because not many of them are laying still. The ones that are laying, the eggs are frozen. Kind of sad. I'm gonna even up it even more. We are gonna add some sesame seeds to this. This is just some white and black sesame seeds. Sprinkle them on top. Oopsie, that did not, I thought it had a thing on it. That's a lot. That's fine. Shoot. Guess I should be looking at what I'm doing and not at the camera. That's the hard thing with cooking and talking at the same time. Okay, let's get the ones out of the oven first. Okay, we'll get these ones in. It says to transfer right away to a cooling rack. Let's get these things away because they spilt everywhere. Did I set the timer? I did not set the timer. 18 minutes. Now that my oven's hot. I know I have oven mitts, but doing this is so much fun. Let these cool now. I don't think we got 80. I think maybe we got like maybe not even 50 of them. We'll see. So I'm gonna wait till this cools down just a little bit before I put the other ones over there on it. So we'll be back when those ones come out and then we'll compare and see which ones we like better. Whether we like the egg wash or whether we like the plain. I'm thinking that the egg wash is gonna give it a little bit more of like a bun taste. We'll see. Okay, these ones are done. You know what I just realized, guys? I did this whole thing without an apron on and I'm slightly got flour all over me. Well, it's not so bad, but I need to remember to put my apron on. That's how I wreck clothes. Okay, let's get these out. I actually need to take my glasses off so I don't fog up. Transferred over. Oh, you know what we need to do first though? We need to get the egg wash on the new batch going in. We'll make these ones without the sesame seeds. Okay, I can't. There's the difference. Let's take this one that I dumped the whole thing on.
Hot. So hot.
It's the inside of them. These very much remind me of like a pasty that you would get in Europe. Very, very much remind, or like a Jamaican patty. Kind of the same idea. Egg wash does do very much for it. I could say I don't really go with the egg wash, but these are good. These are a winner. So I'm gonna get the rest of them finished, but I wanna thank you guys so much for coming along with me today while we experimented with this new recipe. We're gonna have a lot of these for the freezer because we're not gonna eat this many in one setting. But thank you again, guys, for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. I'm also hoping that I don't have sesame seeds in my teeth. Hopefully. I don't have a mirror. I can't check, so sorry if I do. Maybe I'll just go like this. Thanks anyways for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you have a great day or night whenever you're watching this, and I will see you on the next video. Bye, guys.